On Monday, August 14th, the 30-year-old Boardman Chessie Edward was fatally stabbed by a minibus driver after an argument over the driver's position on the minibus queue. Speaking in the wake of the incident, President of the Gros Islet Minibus Association, Danny Edward, has extended condolences to the victim's family. The deadly encounter has reignited public discussion about the general conduct of minibus drivers and their suitability to work in the public transport sector. The Minibus Association president reveals that the driver in question is one who has had complaints brought against him, having been suspended at least once for his behavior.
We have got a few complaints about him. We have dealt with him. I know he has been suspended. We have taken to our disciplinary committee. So this is an individual that we have had, I would say, complaints made against him. But all the complaints have been dealt with.
Members of the public have raised concerns as to why a driver who has had numerous complaints brought against him has been permitted to continue to operate on the route. Edward, however, explains that due process must take place when a complaint is brought against the driver. In some instances, complainants fail to appear before the disciplinary committee to present their case.
With that individual, a lot of that people just want to make a complaint, but they don't want to come and represent or give evidence. Our disciplinary committee. So this is one of the reasons why a lot of the complaints just go as a complaint and have not been dealt with, because individuals who made the complaint do not want to at least give evidence of or go through the abnormal justice or the due process.
The Gros Islet Minibus Association is one which has had several training workshops to improve the service delivery of its drivers. These include anger management and customer service workshops. However, there is so much that can be done by the association, Edward laments. He has called on the Transport Ministry to adopt recommendations that have been put forth by his association and the National Council on Public Transport to have a bus driver certification process to weed out unsuitable drivers from the public transport sector.
I think it's time now the ministry take the bus sector a little more serious. I think it's time now we should go through the certification program for minibus drivers, but not just because you are able to drive a bus or you have a certain years of driving experience that give you the right to drive a bus. I mean, driving a bus is a serious business. Customer service, you deal with a number of persons on a daily basis. So I think that would be left to the ministry to put the requirement or the right legislation in place to govern the bus sector. I think right now that's the way to go. We need to go through a certification program, and that has to be done at the ministry level.
Meanwhile, the president of the One-Way Route has sought to reassure passengers of the organization's commitment to raising standards.
There's been patience with the Gros Islet Minibus Association. I know I've been saying that for a very long time. We are working. We have a proper structure in place for any complaints and disciplinary matters. So appealing to them, any complaints that they have, feel free that they could reach out to the Gros Islet Minibus Association, and I could rest assured that the complaints will be taken seriously, and if there is merit, it will be dealt with.
For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.